Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at files stored on iCloud Drive and how they are and are not backed up. Now, there's a lot of confusion over iCloud Drive files and using Time Machine. These files are not backed up in the same way as files on your hard drive would be. So let's look at the different reasons why you may need a backup file of something and how this relates to iCloud Drive files. So the first reason that you may need a backup is in case of a catastrophic failure. Say your Mac is stolen or it's damaged or it's just some sort of hard drive failure or something like that. In that case, you don't have to worry about the iCloud Drive files because they're automatically synced to Apple servers. You have all of your documents here in these preset folders for Keynote, Numbers, Pages, etc. And you also have your own files you've stored in iCloud Drive of any file type you want. They're all synced with Apple servers, so you get your new Mac or your restored Mac and you just simply log on with your iCloud account, and now under iCloud Drive you'll have all your files again. You can even go to another Mac temporarily and be able to log on and see all your files on iCloud Drive. So iCloud Drive automatically takes care of one of the primary reasons that you have backup, is just to protect these files in case of catastrophe. Okay, so the second reason that you may need a backup is to revert to a previous version of a file. Now, this is where Time Machine usually comes in for a document that's on your hard drive. And Time Machine is now actually a few years old and was developed before a lot of the current software saved things in versions. iCloud Drive files aren't really saved in Time Machine this way. If we enter Time Machine here and we're looking at Pages documents, we'll see that we don't really have any version history here. We have our current files all saved. We don't have the previous versions of these files. I know I've created many versions of this file, for instance, and there's nothing there. There's no previous versions to restore to. So what do you do when you want to get a previous version? Well, the thing is, with modern files like files saved in Pages and lots of other apps, you don't need to use Time Machine for that. You can go into the file itself. So I'll open up this one here in Pages, and if I go to File, I can go Revert to, Browse All Versions, and it opens up a Time Machine-like interface, but I'm not in Time Machine. And I actually have the previous versions of the file here. So I can go back, for instance, to different times and I can view the previous versions of the file. So like here's one before I just added this image. I can restore this version here. I can click on it and even select a text from it and objects from it and copy. So I don't even have to restore if it's just a piece of text or something I want to get. And this is actually much more useful than the previous way of doing it with Time Machine, because every time you hit Save, Command S, it's saving a new version of the file. So if you have a document you're rapidly developing, you can do that every few minutes or every time you do something important in it. You're not relying on this once an hour backup thing, and you're also not relying on the fact that you've got enough hard drive space, because those versions are going to get cleared out as you run out of hard drive space and they need to get replaced with newer versions of things. So you have complete control over how many versions and when the versions are saved by just hitting Command S at any time. And this works for all the main Apple apps and a lot of third-party apps now as well. Now, a third reason that you want to have a backup is in case you accidentally delete a file. And this happens occasionally. This is when you select a file and you just get rid of it and you want to restore it. Now, Mac users are lucky here because you've got a failsafe. Say I select this file and I shouldn't be deleting it, but I hit Command Delete anyway. Since it's an iCloud Drive file, I'm going to get this extra warning here. So it's a little harder to accidentally delete a file. But say I do it anyway. I delete it. Now it's gone. And it's not going to appear in Time Machine, because Time Machine is only going to keep the most recent snapshot, which is this. But it does go into the trash can. So I look in Trash and I see there's the file. And I can control click on it and put back, or I can simply drag it out of the trash can and in there. So for Mac users, you've got that safety mechanism of the trash can. If you're in the habit of throwing things away by putting them in the trash and immediately emptying trash, that's probably a habit to get out of. You don't want to do that. It kind of defeats the purpose of trash. I only delete or empty the trash every once in a while. I've got plenty of hard drive space. If you're running out of hard drive space, then you may want to consider a larger hard drive or cleaning off some files, because you should have enough hard drive space to save some things you've recently deleted in the trash and protect files from this problem. Now iOS users are out of luck here, because if you do delete something in iOS, say in the pages document area, it'll be gone. There is no trash can there to be saved. So hopefully it's something Apple is going to address at some point, is the ability to recover from this mistake of deleting a file that you shouldn't delete. Okay, so that's for these app folders here for like Keynote, Numbers, Pages, etc. What happens if I go to, say, a folder I created on my own and just store some miscellaneous documents in, and I delete a file there? So I've got this don't delete.txt, command delete. I confirm I want to delete it, and I realize, wait a minute, I shouldn't have deleted that. I still have it in the trash can, so I can put it back from there. But in this case, since this is a folder I created, not one of these default ones, I also have it in Time Machine. So I'm going to enter Time Machine with that folder selected. It's very important to remember to do that. And you'll see it as it currently is, but I can also go back in time here, and I can see there's my don't delete saved at an earlier backup. So Time Machine backups for this purpose do work, as long as you don't use those regular app folders. Now I'm hoping Apple changes this, because there's no reason why they can't have Time Machine working just fine in the regular folders, the like Keynote, Numbers, Pages folders, as well as in folders you create on your own.